is one of the most necessary problems to humans. Yes, I'm talking about the environment and the climate change, especially in our province, Quảng Ninh. So, as you know that the environment and the climate change is always a hot issue in our country, in particular, in general, in our province in particular. So our province are making the great effort to protect our surroundings as well. But before talking about that, let's find out what is the environment. The environment is everything around us. That is the air we breathe, the water we drink, the land we farm for food and so on. But nowadays, the environment are being polluted. Every day, yes, every day. By who? By us. We are destroying the environment by what we do every day. Everyone knows that Quảng Ninh is a province that's luckily well-checked with some benefits like the National Wonder of the World, the black gold mines and forest. Thanks to the advantages, Quảng Ninh has such a strong development of cows industry, tourism and urbanization. But let's see what we have done with them. Our national resources in more and more exhausted, and with this, our sea is polluted. We are exploiting the minerals too much, and after leaving waste of the mines as high as a mountain, thus contribute to the sea pollution. Additionally, every year the Halong Bay attracts about a million of tourists from everywhere, and coupled with this is the number of pollution of the waste. People throw this out to the sea, and thus becomes a ton of garbage that's floating on the ocean. Yes. So what do we got? What is this? What is this consequence for this? Yes, after a rain, heavy rain or the flood, the water with dirt, with pores, with waste will drop out to the ocean, pollute the ocean, and it's resolved the bad problem like the water isn't fresh anymore. The marine animal and plant is killed. Yes. And the sea, including our national wonder of the world, is very polluted. So it is not only that, the consequence we always see is the flood, the unexpectedly national disaster in recent year. And right in here in Tianjin Town and in Halong City in the season here. And the flood and the landslide in the other places of Quảng Ninh, such as the Uông Bí, Phong Tô, Hoàng Bồ in 2015, 2016 and 2017. And the heavy rain causing the flood in Diễn Đại in last August is a really clear indicator for this. That's all we got. And if you think of the air is safe, it's no. The air in our province is also polluted by the deforestation and the thermal plant. Yes, and people chop the tree down for wood, burn the forest for land, but they don't know that the forest plays an important role in economy. Yes, it balances the ecosystem and clean the air. And as I consider, the mangroves in our province is being destroyed as well. We have to understand that the mangroves play important roles for the economy and environment. It helps us to balance the ecosystem and prevent the flood. Yeah. And moreover, the thermal plant in Mộc Dương and Hà Khánh is also a big reason. That makes our air is heavily polluted. So, that is everything we got, the bad environment to live, the bad health, yes. So it is too late to fix this mistake? Never too late. But we have to do that together. And what can we do? The government, as the awareness of the consequent Vietnam government in general and Quảng Ninh community in particular, have given some measure for this. First of all, a time of law Quảng Ninh community has asked all the locals not to allow any enterprise or factory to the operation without expression, discrimination, degradation of the knowledge of the state, regulatory of the environmental protection, and about the cross industry. Our government has, our government has exploited not too much anymore, yes. And we just put some and what about action? Quảng Ninh has making some objects in our province, such as building the residential waste treatment project in Goto District and Wonbi City. And moreover, Quảng Ninh also carry out a project named the Mangroves Minimize the Bridge, that which was sponsored by the Japanese Red Cross Association. And this project has organized in 22 community and town in Quảng Ninh. The biggest benefit of this project is saving and maintaining the area of the mangrove planted. That is for the government. But as we, what can we do? And in the individual, we can also do some small and simple things to protect our environment. We can reduce the paper we use to save tree and forest, and try to plant as much tree as we can, because the tree is considered an air conditioner of the earth. And we also have to reduce the plastic bag, because it's really hard to recycle. We can use a paper bag instead of, or try to use the plastic bag anyhow. And what is more important is saving the energy by switching off all the electric equipment when they're not in use. And last but not least, dry less. Try to walk in the soft distance instead of using the motorbike or your car, or try to using the public transportation. That is something small, something simple that you can do to save our environment before it's too late. So please, let's join hands to protect our environment before it's too late. That's all my speech.